It is like a framework. It is absolutely a framework where within all sort of managerial and operating tasks are completely performed. Okay. So here, if you have planned in a very right way in the organization and you have a clear vision, what is your objective, goals and visions in the business organization, what do you do is that first, you after that first function, you go for framing out. You go for framing out in a right way and you see that within which framework you can go for completing all the operational and as well as managerial activities here. So the task, whatever is left out, or else the task, whichever is pending, or else the activities which are dealt within the business organization and how you're going to complete those tasks, you just frame it out. Okay. You just go for giving an outline border where who is responsible for whom, who's going to report all these activities to whom. Everything is being assigned in a right way and then it is being taken in the organizational structure. So let me put it up in a very simple sentence here. That is nothing but where the framework is being formatted, where only the manager activities are going to be performed within the business organization. So now let us see in this organizational structure itself, what are the important things to be considered? That is nothing but it specifies the relationship between people. What is this organization structure? I told you that it's a framework where managerial activities are to be performed. And now let me go for discussing it little more elaborately. What is actually consisted in case of this organizational structure? That is nothing but it specifies relationship between the people, work and resources. It means that who and all are going to be designated in which kind of post within that organizational structure, within which department, how many people are going to work, how much of human resources are going to be available, how much of physical resources and financial resources are going to be available, and what kind of relationships you're going to give a connection between this people, that is men, mission, material and money. So when you come to know these things, that is when you create when you establish the relationship between people, that is men, mission, material and money, definitely it will lead to coordination among human, physical and financial resources. So this becomes one of the important part here, very important part here, where you get a clear clarification that how many members are going to work in one department and how many missionaries are going to be involved over there and what kind of physical resources has to be adopted. Everything will be given out in this organizational structure. And one more important concept to be discussed in organizational structure, that is nothing but span of management. If someone asks you what is span of management, it goes in a very simple way. What is that? It refers to the number of subordinates that can be effectively managed by a superior. So here it is very clearly said that how many subordinates are available, and if you are appointing one person as a production manager, how many subordinates you're going to put under that production manager, whether he will be able to manage them effectively and efficiently, whether like he will be like authoritative and it's responsibility. His responsibility will increase only for this 10 members, or else even if you put 15 subordinates, whether like your manager will be able to manage in an effective and efficient way. So you should be very clear. See, so for example, like in one section, in one class, there are maximum 75 students. Okay. So 75 students itself, sometimes we really feel so tough to manage. And as well as even if we go for conducting some tests and when we go for correcting the papers also, in a class, when lot of strength is there, we cannot go for giving a specific attention to them. Okay. A very exclusive attention towards them. So what happens is here, why do they tell that like you reduce it, you just go for reducing the strength so that you can go for concentrating more upon each and every individual. So in a similar way, Like as this example tells you that if there is more strength, it is not so easy to concentrate on each and every individual student over here. So in a similar way, even in an organization under the production department or under the financial department, if you go for dumping 120 subordinates, definitely a manager cannot go for doing the work so efficiently. So organizational structure is formed by taking the span of management. Span of management is nothing but where you come to know with an exact picture how many subordinates are ready to work under each superior. Okay, by taking this as a base, you go for structuring out the levels of management, and you go for structuring out the relationship between people, machinery, and as well as with all sort of resources. So organizational structure is something where you format with the framework, where the managerial and operational activities are regulated with the help of span of management. So now we'll come to the classification here. The structure, that is organizational structure, it is being classified into two types, girls. One is functional structure and one more is divisional structure. So today I am going to discuss about functional structure. Okay, we are going to deal with this functional structure very clearly. Okay, so let us start with the functional structure today. So here, what do you mean by functional structure? Grouping of jobs of similar nature under functional and organizing. These major functions as separate departments creates a functional structure. So let me explain you. If any of the activities are having similar kind of nature, if any of the job is having a similar kind jobs with similar kind of nature, you group them together. After grouping them together, what you do is that you put them in one separate department. You call this entire process as functional organizational structure. Okay, so I'm repeating it once again. If someone asks you, what do you mean by functional structure? You group the jobs which is having a similar nature, and you put all this similar nature job into one particular department to function in the organization. So this becomes the entire concept of the functional organizational structure. So when I tell you the meaning, only to some extent you will come to know. So let me explain you with the help of chart here. So here, if you take, let me give you one example of educational institution, and then I will come to the explanation of this management chart here, functional structures chart here. If you take an organizational level of an educational institution, how it comes here? So that is managing committee. First will be the managing committee, and next will be the principal, and the next will be the vice principal, headmistress, and teachers. I hope so you are getting the flow here. The flow of chart is nothing but managing committee, principal, vice principal, headmistress, and teachers. This is the flow chart. Now, managing committee, they go for deciding what should be the objective, goals, and as well as what kind of target has to be achieved in the educational institution. This is the actual target of each and every educational institution, and managing committee goes for deciding that. And whatever is being decided in the managing committee, that is passed to the principal. And principal goes for passing that information to vice principal. And whatever the order and the communication level, whatever it might be there, the important concepts, whatever is there, that is being transferred. That is being transferred from the managing committee to the teachers. Okay. So this is the flow of chart in case of one small educational institution. Now, if you go for looking into the organizational structure, that is in the management structure, and if you concentrate on the functional structure, so I'll just clear it for you, like how it is traveling. So chief executive officer, or else you can say managing director, okay, MD of the organization. And now look into the second line here. That second line in sense, that is from. Could you hear me, girls? Please give me a clarification. Could you hear me? Yes, thank you. So here, board of directors, from board of directors, you just pass the information and the direction towards the chief executive officer. And from chief executive officer, you go for differentiating or designating with some 4 to 6 departments here. 6 departments in sense that is like we can say sales and marketing department, production department, human resources department, finance department, research and development department, purchasing department. So now what happens is that sales and marketing in sense that whatever the work which is involved in marketing and sales department, I group together and I put it up. Now could you hear me? Could you hear me, girls? Response to me. Could you hear me? Okay. So now, these kind of activities which is involved in case of sales department and as well as production department, each and every department is possessed with different activities here. So all these activities are grouped together and which is having a similar sort of activities are put into one particular department. Okay. So that department, I call it as what? Sales department, marketing department, production department, human resource department, finance department, research and development department, purchasing department. So keep one point very clearly in your mind, girls. If someone asks you, what is functional organizational structure? Put it in a very simple thing in your mind. That is nothing but I group the jobs which is having similar nature. And I put up all the similar nature activities in one particular department. I never go for merging up the departments or else the activities of different natured jobs here. So production department, what work will go in production department? That is bringing of raw material, conversion of raw material into finished product and all such things. Unit, you go for producing. And if you take an example of financial department, what work you'll go for performing accountant work and petty cash maintenance and how you can go for taking care of all the financial activities. All these things become so clear with one group of activities and you just put it up into one single departments. So this goes in a very clear way. So you just go for separating the divisions, separating the departments, grouping the activities which is having with a similar nature and put it up in one particular departments. Now let us see what are the advantages and disadvantages in case of functional organizational structure. So let me start with advantages of functional organizational structure. Functional specialization becomes one of the important benefit which comes in the functional organizational structure. So here what happens is that when you start recruiting the people or when you start assigning the work to the each and every individual and when they start working in that particular department years together, for example, like 5 years, 10 years, if one person is working as a marketing manager, he becomes so specialized in that particular department. He just goes through so many difficulties, so many challenges in that particular department. And if anything goes wrong or else if any unexpected things happens in that particular department, he goes goes for facing it very boldly. What makes him to goes for facing it? It is nothing but the experience what he has gained throughout that 10 to 15 years. So he becomes expert in that. When you start recruiting the people and when you go for assigning the right job for the person who's really fitted for that job, he goes for doing the activities in a very regulated manner, in a very unique manner. So all his creative and innovative ideas gets launched in that particular department, and he feels that he and that department are one. He gets that kind of zeal in himself to prove that his department is specialized and expertized in one particular production of a product. So here, when they start giving, in case of functional organizational structure, when you give one person one complete department, he becomes specialized in that. So this becomes one of the advantage in case of functional structure. And what is the second point to be discussed here? That is second advantage here, that is nothing but promotes control and coordination. As you go for assigning the authority and responsibility between different departments and different people, they are having a clarity among their relationships. So at once, when you go for giving all these assignments of duties and jobs over here, This really creates coordination among each and every employees. Okay. And they go for having control over the work over there. No one gets confused. No one gets any sort of misunderstanding. They have a very clear view that similar task, whatever is being performed in each and every department, it is being performed by the designated authoritatives. So they have a very clear vision here, what kind of work they have to perform and what kind of activities they have to go in with that. So this is having a controlling power. It promotes the functional organizational structure. It promotes the controlling power and it creates coordination among the employees. And the third one is giving you one good point here. What is that? Increases managerial and operational efficiency. Functional organizational structure, it creates operational and managerial efficiency. Could you remember the meaning of efficiency, girls? What do you mean by efficiency? Complete the task in time with minimum cost. This is the meaning of efficiency. So here, functional organizational structure, it initiates towards the efficiency of management. When everyone are having a particular department, when everyone are having a clear thought about what they are working over here, what is the objective of each and every department, what happens is here, it gives you a very good result. What kind of result? That is, activities are performed in right time. And that is, tasks are performed in right time and they go for reducing the cost here. Okay. At once, when you go for reducing the cost by minimum wastage of resources, definitely it increases the managerial efficiency in the business organization. And now coming to the fourth advantage, it leads to minimum duplication of work. Okay, so that is something like we can say one particular task is not given to two of the candidates here, two of the authoritative people. Only one candidate is very clear under which machinery he has to get operated and how many products he needs to produce. Everything is clearly instructed by the functional structure here. So no need to get any chaos or misunderstanding here. No confusions at all. There is no chance of ambiguity. So completely they go for getting an information how they are going to work, under whom they are going to be a subordinate, and who is their superior, who is their boss. Everything is clear. At that point of time, what happens is that duplication of the work reduces. When duplication of work reduces, the cost of the product also reduces. Ultimately, the cost, when it gets reduced, it increases the efficiency automatically. So this becomes one of the important advantage in case of functional structure. And now coming to the next point here, that is nothing but different, that is, training of employees becomes easier. When you start giving training to the employees, when you start giving the skilled training to each and every employees, no need to give for entire different departments. If you feel that the training of employees of financial department is necessary, you go for giving them a separate training and you go for cultivating that training process in an efficient work. And you see that only that group of people are trained. So functional structure, it makes the training process much easier. And apart from this, the last one is giving you, that is each department, each function is getting focused. Each department is seen separately. The result of each and every department is giving you a conclusion. It is giving you a particular departmental function in a very clear view. So there is no any misunderstanding, and as well as you get a complete picture whether production department is doing well or marketing department is doing well. All these things are clearly seen in case of functional organizational structure. So this is about advantages of functional organizational structure. The last concept to be discussed here, disadvantages of functional organizational structure. I just think like to complete, I'm about to complete the session, that is with this disadvantages. What are the disadvantages you're getting here? That is, many of them, what do they do is that in each department, they concentrate more only upon their own department objective. But the main target should be, they should go for concentrating upon overall organizational goals and objectives. But many people, they get some sort of competitive spirit and they really feel like glowing in the way of achieving the objective of their own departments only. Okay, so they wanted to have a very competitive nature, like they concentrate more only on the marketing department objective, production department objective or something like that. They never go for targeting or concentrating more upon the organizational overall goals and overall objectives. And next one is conflict of interest. Okay, so conflict of interest in sense that is something like we can say when sales department is telling to give 10% discount on the product, financial department will not agree for the 10% discount. It will ask the sales department to inform only 5% discount on the product is available. So that creates lot of issues, that creates lot of conflict, that creates lot of a quarrel between each and every departments here. So that doesn't give actually a coordination. And the next one to be discussed, difficult to fix responsibility. Many of the candidates will be so good enough, okay, and they'll be talented enough. Sometimes confusion arises, like who should, like for example, you see, if a product, one newly launched product is not running successfully in the market. Now, research and development analysis, they wanted to make one analysis and come to a conclusion. Which department to give responsibility to make this product to run successfully in the market? Like whether to give in case of production department, whether to give in human resource department, they get confused. Okay. So here, when that kind of confusion creates here, they really get a problematic, like they go for facing certain problems. Whom to give, that is like to whom to give the responsibility, who will take the initiative. So all such things becomes one of the disadvantage in case of functional organizational structure. And the last one, managerial development becomes so difficult here. Okay, because as you know that like different departments with different objective, they concentrate more only on those objective. And finally, what happens is that like they face certain difficulties, okay, where they go for finding so bad, or else we can say they go for finding, you know, they just make that they become so difficult to develop the personal, to develop the activities of each and every individual. They are not able to coordinate because of that competitive level, because of that challenging task between each and every department. So this gives you a clear vision of functional organizational structure and as well as advantages and as well as disadvantages.